The Stop the War Coalition has enjoyed the support of a lot of writers, a lot of journalists, and many people who've given their time and energy to it. One who's written brilliantly for a different foreign policy, a different approach, and for peace and for justice is our great friend, who's going to come onto the stage and speak now, Seumas Milne. Welcome, Seumas.
Thanks, Jeremy, and thanks to all of you for coming today to Trafalgar Square. Now, it's 10 years since the invasion of Afghanistan and the launch of the war on terror, a war that has since spread to Iraq and Pakistan, from Palestine to Lebanon, Somalia to Yemen, and now in Libya today. It's a war with no end in sight. It's not a war on terror, but a war of terror, that has killed hundreds of thousands of people, made millions refugees, and spread terrorism, resistance, and savage repression. Now, 10 years ago, the anti-war movement warned that the invasion of Afghanistan and then Iraq would lead to disaster. It wouldn't deliver democracy, it wouldn't liberate women, it wouldn't defeat terrorism, and it wouldn't bring peace. But the very opposite. 10 years on, in one country after another, we have been proved right, and the politicians and propagandists, blinded by imperial arrogance, have been proven horrifically wrong. But still they don't give up. Once again today, the United States, Britain, and NATO are in action in another Arab and Muslim country, and this time it's Libya. And this time they said it would all be different. There would be no boots on the ground. The Libyans would be in charge. The aim was protection of civilians. Tell that to the thousands of civilians who have been forced to flee, who have been wounded and have been killed by the bombardment of NATO and NATO-backed forces now in the Libyan town of Sirte. Tell that to the families of the estimated 20,000 dead who have been killed since NATO intervened and vetoed one ceasefire and set of negotiations after another. Tell that to the black workers who have been lynched by pro-NATO forces across Libya. And instead of Libyans being in control, NATO is now threatening to intervene if the wrong people end up in charge. Libya is not a humanitarian intervention, but an attempt to hijack the Arab revolution that can only lead to more conflict. Because of course, these wars are not about terrorism or dictatorship, but an attempt to force Western domination and control of resources across the Arab and Muslim world, and now to save NATO's face. The political class knows it's lost the battle for public opinion on Afghanistan and the war on terror, especially now it's being paid for by cuts at home, which is why they're talking about an exit strategy in 3 years' time. But it's not happening on the ground, and it's not what they're actually planning in 2015. So our job is to turn public hostility to the war into unstoppable pressure to end it. Let the people of Afghanistan and the Arab and Muslim world decide their own future and bring the troops home. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Seumas. Thanks for your writing and the brilliant message you gave today.